We can use the analogy that we're the patients, and we need the power for the air conditioning and the fans to keep us well. We went to the operating room where they take the pulse and make sure the patients are getting what we need.
This is Duke Energy's System Operating Center in Charlotte, the nerve center they use to know how much power is going where and how quickly it needs to go.
Our projection is to be able to meet our customer demand and our reserve obligations over the next several days. Now, we're analyzing that all the time to make sure we're prepared for contingencies that may happen.
The grid on the wall shows the southeast area of the country. Inside the blue line is the Duke Power area, which includes the Piedmont. Graphs show the energy supply and the demand. On the floor, workers man three different stations 24/7. Director of System Operating Sam Holman explains each station has a different responsibility.
He's looking at the big picture from the Rockies to the Northeast down to Florida. He's kind of doing inventory. His job is to make sure that he can account for the megawatt and megawatt hours that are engaging or involving our system. And he's making sure we're in balance. We've got enough load to meet our, enough generation to meet our load demand.
The excessive heat strains the power system, so Duke Energy prepares Plan Bs and Plan Cs in case problems arise at some points on the grid.
We look at loss of generation assets. We look at loss of components to the system. We play that what-if game. What if this happens? How are we going to respond?
If a certain power station goes out or can't generate any more power, then the order goes out for another station to make more. Especially at a time like this, when a heat wave spreads across most of the country, some power from our area might go towards a different area, and vice versa.
We're all interconnected, and electricity travels at close to the speed of light, so it's a very complex, real-time process.
And what they told us follows logic. If there's one hot day or two hot days, that's not that big of a deal. It's when there is an extended period of hot days, 5, 10, 15-day heat wave, that's when the system gets under tremendous stress.